everyone, and welcome back as always. Skol! We like doing this. Yay. We're taking advantage of our Viking bugs. Yay! So we are, of course, very excited about Game of Thrones coming out. We're watching some teaser trailers, you know, all kinds of things right now on Game of Thrones, the channel, through YouTube, and they have a lot of videos out right now called The Cast Remembers, and they just came out a little while ago, and I'm like, holy crap, that's a lot of people. So we're just going to pick one for now, because we're going to see what we can do tonight, but I definitely want to see the one with Emilia Clarke on playing Daenerys Targaryen, that's what it says, because I did mention on social media, but because we haven't been reacting to Game of Thrones, because we're caught up, and now we're going to be for the new season, I wanted to mention on video, too, that all of us were really shocked in what she went through when she opened up about what happened to her with her aneurysms and everything.
Yes.
And insane. Like, oh, my God. And we have family, our side, and through Wookiee's side, too, like family members who've had that who haven't survived. It's absolutely crazy. So in her case, I'm very happy that she's doing okay, but it's still extremely scary.
It's always going to be in the back of her head. What,
yeah,
I mean, is it going to ever happen again? Or
exactly. And going through something like that, especially at such a young age, and thinking that you're going to die, like that's extreme.
That's right.
And she also is under a lot of pressure through her job too, because being an actress with a big show, I can't imagine like how many hours.
Remembering your lines and just keep going.
Yeah,
and
a lot of pressure of just being in front of a lot of people. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of money involved all the time. You want to do a good job. You have to look good. You have to have the emotion there, and it's just crazy.
Right, but even just the foundation of remembering your lines.
I know.
If you have a blood bleed, brain bleed,
it's insane. Absolutely insane. Mm. So if you haven't read the article, I'll try to look that up and post it in the description below, because it's really worth the read. And she was, I don't know if it's the right word to say, but she was so adorable and a wonderful person. And it's emotional. Like, she actually put a big thank you on video through Twitter to like thank her fans and family and friends and stuff for really responding to what she opened up about, because she kept it secret for so long, because I can't imagine, you don't want that stuff out, I guess, right away. She's already under so much pressure, and it's personal, and it's scary. So I'm sure her story is going to help a lot of people who have been through that situation and family that haven't survived it. So it's a major thing. It's scary. Mm-hmm. So not to, you know, make this dreadful or anything, but I definitely wanted to say that, because I was like, holy crap, when I first saw it on there, and I just sat and I just read what, you know, her article, and I'm really happy that she opened up about it now and discussed it, because I can tell
we
she
love
feels
you,
better.
Amelia.
We love you. You were so amazing. And we know that you have a wonderful support system. Skol to Amelia, you are so amazing, and I'm happy things, neck of wood, are going good for you, and I hope that's the end of that, and you won't ever have to worry about that ever again. But yes, so we're going to be watching The Cast Remembers, Emilia Clarke on playing Daenerys Targaryen. So the first one we'll see. It's not in order, but hopefully it doesn't matter.
I started this job when I was 22, and I am not 22 anymore. The journey that I've been on with Daenerys, it's sharpened me as an actor. And because of the heights that she goes to, it's forced me to find them within myself. And so anytime anything good or bad happens, you put it into her. So Daenerys is a tapestry of my entire adult life. Within each major scene of Daenerys is every major scene of my life.
So freaking epic, I love it. And there's some music too. The Cast Remembers. Skol!
Yeah, I remember my first day on set. Oh my god, I fell off a fucking horse. This is my first job. This is like the first thing I ever did, and they stuck me on a horse.
Oh my god.
In a bamboo field in Belfast, and it's raining. I was falling off the horse trying to act still. A Khaleesi.
Okay. I don't know where it's
going to fall into. I mean, literally, I'm like hanging on like this, and I'm hanging on for dear life, and I just remember shouting, please stop filming. And I'm like, okay, everything's going to be fine. Turn around, and I'm like, oh my god, there's like the whole crew, and I just cried. So that was my first day on Game of Thrones. That was it. Hey, Mom, I had a really good day. I had more spine tingly, goosebump, joyful, punch the air, yay days on this show than anything in my life. It's the thing about Dani. Every season she gets better. Every season there's something else bigger than the last season and better than the last season.
That was
a cool scene. We just watched that with Nick and Lee.
Season 3, Getting the Unsullied, was the first time that I, Amelia, got to be, you know, like, bitch and badass. Dracarys. It was really cool.
That
rubs off on you as an actor. You feel it. I have had to stand up and be Daenerys. In all of these moments, I've had to stand on that rock and speak to a lot of people.
Yeah.
In a crazy language.
Yeah.
It's been a challenge.
It's
but
so different.
You just have to grow a pair and do it.
Oh my gosh.
Gosh, she's so great.
Leaving this show is leaving a part of me. The people are just... Can I take Peter? Can I take Nani? Oh, yes. Can I take them all? How can I rule 7 kingdoms?
Drama.
If I can't control Slaver's Bay, why should anyone follow me?
You're a Targaryen. You're the mother of dragons.
There's an ease that I get with acting with Ian Glen because he's been my pal the whole time.
Aww, yeah, that's true.
My buddy. Shambles, darling, shambles. Ian is an incredible actor and he is an incredible mentor. He's just helped me as a person on a really real level.
Nice.
I start to cry. This is ridiculous.
Aww.
That's cute.
This is always a safe space. We can have fun and we can take the piss out of each other and we can support each other and we can laugh at each other's jokes or we can laugh at each other's bad moods or we can, it's a family, it's an absolute family. There's no ego, there's no, we're in it together.
Oh,
I'm never gonna get that again.
As much as for your dress. I'd be like, ah, we're white guys.
Game of Thrones has set me free. It's literally given me my freedom as a human being and as an actor and as a woman. I've been able to play this incredibly strong woman when I could have very easily never thought of the places that I had to go to with her, the strength that I had to find to play her, and then seeing that I had that strength myself. And that's a really big deal. And these guys have taken care of me so much, and I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm really lucky to get to have it documented. And I'll just be forever grateful to everyone who makes Game of Thrones for giving me something really special.
Aww, that's nice. Yeah! She has such good emotion behind that, too. Like, it's sad,
fantastic.
But it's so happy, too. Oh, I love how they're bringing out these videos, because I was like, oh my god, they have so many at the same time. That was so emotionally
part of her, you know, her life.
Yeah. Everything that she said in this, like, you felt what she was saying, and as a human being, I'm like, oh my god, like, she's so compassionate, and I love her.
Oh, she's so
oh my god. So I can't imagine, like, being involved with something like that, where when you're doing Game of Thrones, like, each season's probably, like, a year, you know? And so you have so many years of doing this, and these people are your family. And all of a sudden, now that it's over, it's like you kind of hope they can do spin-offs or something
it's so
they can continue on.
Yeah.
It's always sad when something ends, but I know.
At least their own personal reunions, you know, they can do.
Yeah.
It's so good they all get along.
Yeah.
Very well, you know.
Yeah, and that's so important. And I love the really awesome relationship she has with, what was his name? Ian? I love him as Jorah, and he's just so great.
Oh, yes.
And I love how they had a true relationship also on the show, and he was like a mentor to her. Like, that means a lot, too. And I love seeing people being goofy. There was one lady in the background. I'm sure, like, people get so tired, you know. She was just, like, deadpanning at Amelia, like,
too,
what are you being silly for? But who knows? Maybe she didn't realize she was being recorded either. But, like, doing that all the time and just endless
and for
hours
in the costumes and, you know.
I give her credit, too, because I can't imagine being nude on a popular, on anything, right. but on such a popular show mm-hmm. in front of all these people that you know, and then you have cameras all around you. And I did hear, I think a fan told us a while ago that Amelia actually, I know I'm saying her actual name, but Amelia actually said that she didn't want to expose herself on the show anymore, so they started to CGI her body or her head onto someone else's body over time. But anyways, like, small part of how awesome she is to be that brave to do something like that, mm-hmm. but to be able to express this character and how she feels it, and I love how she enjoys being Daenerys, because that really shows on the show. Like, she is so realistic.
And she was phenomenal with all those Conquerors, you know, episodes. She had this little scene.
It's so true.
Oh, like, she was phenomenal.
All the arcs are great, but they're sad and everything, and she, you know, has a lot of sad things that happen as well, but everything is so powerful with her that she just dominates, and you're like,
the dragons are behind her.
So freaking epic, yeah.
She drew along the story.
Yeah, she did. And it was awesome seeing the dragons grow, too, every single season. It was like, holy crap, look how big they got. And then they're so freaking massive by last season. It was, like, insane. But I just love how she has so much passion and the way she talks about it. She almost started crying. I almost started crying. She's like, oh, my God, I can really feel it in her, you know? And she seems kind of goofy in a fun way.
Oh, like, yeah. Well, you know, just like she had to, you know, speak the different tongue. And she was like,
I can't even imagine. And I know the dragons aren't really there.
In front
there,
of all those people, she said.
Yeah, and actually seeing the dragons, or, like, you see the dragons for a second, and then it's, like, the green model. And then she's still so dramatic. Like, I give her props for that, too. Because can you imagine? You have to imagine all that there.
Imagine, great imagination.
And you have to really believe it. And just being like that, I'd be laughing hysterically. Like, that's why I'm not an actress. But I do appreciate what she does and what everyone else does on the show. And I definitely want to watch another one, if not more, just to see, like, what everyone else has to say. Because that was pretty cool. So thank you, Amelia Clark, for sharing this with us. Because we are very excited to watch you on Game of Thrones. The last season, bittersweet, but I'm very, very happy, and this is really cool to watch. Yes. So thank you so much for watching,
thank
and we'll
you.
See you very soon, as always. Bye-bye! Bye. A different bye.
Bye-bye.
Skull.
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 Cha-ching.